Good morning, dear students. We have completed aldehyde and ketone from the chapter aldehyde, ketone and carboxylic acid. The third chapter of second book. Now, today we will start the last topic of this chapter, that is carboxylic acid, and we will start with the method of preparation of carboxylic acid. So before that, RC double bond OH or RCOH is the general representation of carboxylic acid, and their general molecular formula can be written as CnH2n plus 1 COH or CnH2nO2. Please remember, in organic chemistry, we have two organic compounds which contains two oxygen atoms, and the two compounds are carboxylic acid and esters. Esters also follows this general molecular formula CnH2nO2. So we can say that esters exhibit functional isomerism with carboxylic acid because their general molecular formula is same, but the functional group present is different. Now let us move to the method of preparation. The first method is by the oxidation of primary alcohols. You know it very well that primary alcohols undergoes oxidation and these form aldehyde first. Aldehydes are highly susceptible towards oxidation, so we cannot stop the reaction on aldehyde only. So aldehyde undergoes further oxidation, as a result we get carboxylic acid. So primary alcohols having general representation as RCH2OH. In presence of oxidizing agent like acidic KMnO4, acidic K2Cr2O7, alkaline KMnO4 or alkaline K2Cr2O7 will give you RCOH, which is the representation for carboxylic acid. So what you have to remember, the CH2OH unit gets converted to COOH unit on oxidation of primary alcohols. If the number of carbon atoms are n, then in carboxylic acid also the number of carbon atoms will be n. It is the first method. Now we can use aldehyde also, as we know that primary alcohols first forms aldehyde. Aldehyde on further oxidation gives carboxylic acid, so we can use aldehyde also. So aldehyde, which are represented as RCHO on oxidation, gives you RCOH. The CHO unit gets converted to COOH. There is no change in the number of carbon atoms. If the starting aldehyde molecules contain n number of carbon atoms, then carboxylic acid will also contain n number of carbon atoms. So there will be no change in the number of carbon atoms. Then we have third method, by the complete hydrolysis of alkyl cyanide. Please remember one point here, it's a very useful concept. CN group on complete hydrolysis gets converted to COOH, and this complete hydrolysis can take place in presence of dilute HCl, where the CN molecule utilizes two molecules of water. And by utilizing two molecules of water, CN group is directly converted to COOH. So, on complete hydrolysis, RCN, which are cyanides, gets converted to RCOH. Remember, the reaction will take place in presence of dilute HCl, where it will utilize two molecules of water. Then the next reaction, by the hydrolysis of amides. So here, reaction number 3 takes place in two steps. RCN utilizes first molecule of water, and by utilizing first molecule of water, it gets converted to acetamide. Acetamide utilizes second molecule of water, and by the utilization of second molecule of water, amides gets converted to RCOH. So the complete hydrolysis takes place in two steps. RCN first gets converted to RCONH2, and RCONH2 then gets converted to RCOH. So here we can say that we can also use acetamide, maralkinamide, for the preparation of carboxylic acid. So here RC double bond to NH2 in presence of dilute HCl undergoes hydrolysis, where C double bond to NH2 group utilizes one molecule of water, and by the utilization of one molecule of water, it gets converted to RCOH with the removal of NH3. Then comes the last reaction, that is from Grignard reagent, a type of addition reaction where we will add carbon dioxide to Grignard reagent. You know it very well that Grignard reagent is RMGS, alkyl magnesium halide. Carbon dioxide is C double bond O. The reaction takes place in presence of dry ether. What happens? The CO2 molecule get inserted in between R and Mg. As a result, we get addition product, which can be written as R C double bond O O MgX. Now, this addition product on hydrolysis gets converted to R C double bond OH with the release of MgOHX, hydroxy magnesium halide. So it's all about the method of preparation of carboxylic acid. In next class, we will talk about the chemical properties of carboxylic acid. That's all for today. Have a good day. Thank you.